all I knew going into it was that I was going to be writing something that was about a woman killing men.
Welcome to another episode of the BBC Africa Book Club, a series about African art and literature. I'm Princess Irede Abumere. Let's get straight into this episode. Today we'll be reviewing My Sister, the Serial Killer by Oyinkan Braithwaite. Before we get into it, I should probably tell you that this is a special episode because we have the author herself with us. Welcome, Oyinkan.
Thank you for having me.
I'm glad you could join us. All right, let's get straight into it. With your permission, I'm just going to read the first chapter. Okay. The first chapter is titled Words. Ayola summons me with these words. Kurede, I killed him. I hoped I would never hear those words again. So what is your debut novel about?
So my novel is about two sisters. Kurede is the elder sister and Ayola is the younger one. Mm-hmm. And Ayola has the unfortunate habit that she kills off her boyfriends. And Korede, the older sister and the responsible sister, is forced to clean up after her younger, to literally clean up by, you know, getting rid of the blood and all of the evidence. So she has to clean up after Ayola's messes.
Yeah. What made you decide to write a crime thriller?
At the time, I didn't think I was writing a crime thriller. I didn't really think much about genre. All I knew going into it was that I was going to be writing something that was about a woman killing men, and mm-hmm. it was going to explore the relationship between the two female characters, and also was going to engage in this, in what I've always kind of been interested in, which is how society responds and interacts with beauty and beautiful people.
So what kind of research went into your book?
Not a great amount. I think in 2007, like what really birthed the idea for me, I think, was when I was reading up on the Black Widow spider and how after mating with the male spider, if she was hungry and he was still hanging around, she would eat him. And I thought that was hilarious because he wasn't her natural prey, mm-hmm. you know. So there was something really reckless and cruel about it, and it just stayed in my mind. You know, so I think that eventually it's what I used to base Ayola on for the most part.
Okay. Let's talk about the structure of the book, how you've written this. For me, it was an easy read. I read it in a day. It didn't take me that long to read. I could take it in one go. I didn't have to go and keep coming back to it. Some of the chapters are really short, just like the first chapter, which I read earlier. So in these chapters, there's revelation, there's suspense. You keep us waiting and wanting more. Did you write it this way deliberately?
I wrote each chapter in a separate Word document. Mm-hmm. So each chapter was self-contained. So okay. It was important that each chapter had its own mini story, I guess. So maybe that's what, you know, which is why, like, it's got the titles the way it has, because, mm-hmm. you know, some of the time the title was what reminded me, okay, this is what this chapter is about, and kept me rooted in that chapter. I didn't worry too much about what the bigger picture was, and it's what helped me sort of, you know, because it's really hard to finish a novel, and writing it like this and not worrying about, oh, what's the finished product going to be like, made it easier to write, made it less, made it easier for me to just be free, and also allowed me to explore different styles and to do maybe things I wouldn't normally do, not to be worried about length, because a lot of the time you're conscious, I think, well, I'll speak for myself, a lot of times I'm conscious about length, mm-hmm. As, you know, someone who's writing a novel, oh, the novel's got to be this size,
yeah.
and, you know, a chapter's got to be this many words, although it's mm-hmm. not really a chapter, and I didn't have any of those concerns with this particular book, so that's what enabled me to start a chapter, write two sentences, and I'm like, okay, looks like it's done.
What is your favorite chapter, your favorite quote in the book?
You're actually the first person to ask me this. I have no idea what my favorite quote. Okay, two things. One, I think maybe when the father brings home the mistress.
Okay.
And the mom says she speaks in Yoruba, and that line, like, I'm not sure. So what she says in Yoruba, I think in my mind, it was very poetic. I mean, it's in Yoruba, so, and it's not translated in the book, but, you know, I think, you know, like, Yoruba has, it has a, like, Yoruba people have a way of coining, and it's, every language has an interesting way of coining some things, you know, and you know, when they say, like, you know, something in Yoruba, which means, you know, do you want to walk on my head?
Mm-hmm.
You know, which in English wouldn't really make any sense, but in Yoruba, it's almost like, do you want to destroy me, or do you want to, you know, say, I guess, disrespect me in some way?
Yeah.
Like, it's just, so those, I think that I enjoyed that phrase she said. And then also, I think near the last chapter, when, I'm not going to give a spoiler, but when Korede is talking to the police, and I think that, I think that was the point where you can see that she's, you know, she's changed to mm-hmm. some extent. And, you know, I liked that conversation that she had with the police.
I'll tell you what my favorite quote is here. It's from the chapter titled Asleep, where more or less Kurde, it's as though she's being haunted by one of the guys that her sister has killed. And more or less the last sentence where, or the last two sentences where he asked me if he could have done anything differently, and the response is, you could have seen her for what she was. That's my favorite bit. Yeah. Okay. So which character do you relate to the most?
I enjoy Ayala the most. I think I might relate to Korede the most just because I'm also an old, you know, the eldest mm-hmm. of four, and I can appreciate that sense of responsibility and that sense of wanting to protect your younger siblings. But I think hers is a very extreme sort of illustration of that. But yeah, I think I do. I could, and I, you know, I'm writing in her point of view as well, so
yeah.
I had to sort of inhabit what she was going through quite a bit. So I think she would be the character that definitely.
Okay. Let's talk about some of the themes. We know, obviously, there's that whole theme of sisterhood here where Koyeride and Ayola, completely different, but if anything, you can tell that they genuinely love each other and they're there for each other. What other themes would you say there are in your book?
I've been told. do you know what? It's easier to say, like, the themes I've discussed with people because I wasn't, aside from maybe thinking about beauty and mm-hmm. and I guess maybe loyalty as well, I wasn't going into it with themes, you know. So a lot of things you realize after the fact.
Yeah.
So, you know, quite a few people have talked about feminism and the woman taking control of the power that she has.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's also been you know, social media and the social media.
Yes. You do touch on that quite a bit.
Yeah. Family, he said sisterhood, corruption, because mm-hmm. we have with the Alasma. you know, I can't think of any more at
the
top of my
I'd
head.
I'd say anymore. The pressures of society.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, marriage and all those good things.
Or just even keeping up appearances as well.
Mm.
Talking about why someone would say, you know, there's a theme of feminism. So the story is told from Korede's point of view. You have a lot of female voices in the story, and then you have women driving the story. Why did you choose to write it this way?
For the most part, I generally always write about women.
Mm-hmm.
I suppose because I am one, and I find them slightly more interesting. Yeah, it's not really deep. I just find them more interesting to write about. I think their stories, in terms of, you know, a lot of us like to see people triumph, and
mm-hmm.
and we're somewhat accustomed to seeing men get what they want, but like women, not so much. And to see a woman, I think what people enjoyed is seeing a woman in, you know, they're used to seeing stories about, especially crime stories about men yes. killing numerous women.
Yes.
And, you know, I'm using nice, not literally, but I suppose it was nice to see a woman having that power and using it in the mm-hmm. same sort of reckless way.
Okay, so it's a thriller, but there's humor in here. Why did you choose to include this?
So I found out it was funny just before the book came out, when the reviews had started coming through. I didn't realize it was a funny book. What I did know was that, like I said, I didn't want it to be too dark. Mm-hmm. So the characters were really matter of fact, and you know, so I was conscious of that. I think that's why it was funny, where there was this obvious darkness, but you have, you know, these characters who go, right, you know, 1 minute Corridor is cleaning up blood, and the next minute she's like, oh, my food is going to get cold. And your brain tells you, wait, hang on a minute, that doesn't quite jar. And I think it's that contrast that that enabled the humor to happen, but it wasn't.
If this was made into a movie or a TV series, who would you want to play Ayola and Corridor?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't get a lot of, you know, say in that. Like when you sell your rights, there's only so much power you really have, especially as a debut author. Mm-hmm. So I haven't even worried about it, because I know that nobody's going to ask me, like, who do you think would. But I think it would be nice to have, like, at least one or two actual Nigerian actors or actresses. Maybe the other day I was thinking about the role of Yinka, actually, and I was thinking about, now I've forgotten her name. She was in Wedding Party.
Beverly Naya.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So how did you know?
She would kill it. She would kill this role.
Yeah. So I thought about her for Yinka, but I haven't thought about for Corridor Ayala.
Okay. Anything else you want to share with us?
Buy it if you haven't bought it yet. But yeah, so thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for coming on. And that's it from us. If you have any books that you think that we should be reading, or any authors you think we should be speaking to, remember to drop a comment down below. Also, remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and give this video a thumbs up. And let's continue this conversation on social media. Remember to use the hashtag BBC Africa Book Club and follow us on all our social media platforms, BBC News Africa. Until next time.